Ah, I will smack you around my garden.
Look kind of like poop. There's no nice way to put it, but it looks like somebody forgot to flush the toilet. But then again, compost tea is not supposed to be pretty. It's just supposed to work. And that's what it does. Whoops, wrong setting. I just love this thing, but I always have it on the wrong setting. Ooh, I can hit the house from here. It's kind of cool. I love this thing. Okay, anyway, I have this about this full of compost tea. I did an episode, I don't know, a week or so ago on compost tea. And one thing I did leave out is that how to use it. I was sitting there talking about compost and how to put stuff in here and add water, and then I totally left out how I use the compost tea. So I was going to do a little bit of a harvest today, but I thought, while I'm out here, let's go ahead and show you how I use the compost tea. All right. It's about this full because I used some yesterday, and each day I add some water, then I use some compost tea, then I add some water. Now, you don't have to worry about anaerobic bacteria, aerobic bacteria. I know a lot of people commented on that. But the thing is that if you have anaerobic bacteria, which is the bacteria that grow in the absence of oxygen, not to worry, because once you pour it out on the soil, the anaerobic bacteria are extremely weak and they die just like that. So don't worry about it. I've been doing this for decades and I've never gotten sick. Not one single time have I gotten sick. You know, the oddest thing is, the only time I got sick eating vegetables was eating at a salad bar in Hinckley. There was this restaurant that had a salad bar. And I ate from there, and I believe the plates weren't exactly clean. Yeah, I got food poisoning, and anybody that's ever had food poisoning, you know it's not the best day of your life. Oddly enough, I use composted chicken manure, which people, you know, claim, oh, salmonella and all kinds of crazy stuff, and E. coli, and, you know, flying ticks and stuff like that. And you got compost tea, which is basically manure water and blah, blah, blah. You know, I've never gotten sick off my garden. So that should tell you. And I've been gardening for decades. I'm an old gardener, and I've never gotten sick off of this stuff. But what I do is I use a little compost tea, put some more water in, and then once the tea starts looking a little bit, you know, you can see through it, then it's time to just use it all up, pour out the sludge into your garden. But I don't aerate it or anything like that. When I add water like this, that kind of mixes it all around. Then I take my bucket. This is so simple. I don't know why I'm even doing a thing on this, but, and then you might think, ooh, you're sticking your hands in this. Yes, I'm sticking my hands in this. This is what I do. I'm a gardener. I don't wear gloves. I stick my hands in the compost tea, and that's it. Then, to water, I know this seems really simple. All I do is water gently around the plants and let it soak in. Now, if my plants are looking really crappy, I use compost tea every single time instead of water. Then, once the plants are looking good, I take it down to about once every third watering, just for a maintenance program. And, ooh, I don't know why I keep finding these stupid things in here. Oh, microphone problems. Anyway, this is all I do. I just use it and water around the plants. And it soaks right in. Plants love it. Plants love me. Everybody's happy. There. Ray's ridiculously easy addition to his compost tea video. How to use compost tea. Well, that is literally all I do. I'm sorry it's not intricate or anything like that, but I'm not an intricate kind of guy. Now that we're done with that, let's go on to something else. Shall we? I have some stuff that's growing pretty good. By the way, you noticed this, didn't you? Yeah, you noticed this is doing pretty good. It's nice and sturdy. The lettuce underneath here is looking beautiful, but there's something over here that I'm dying to eat, and I didn't want to eat it until I had you here so that we could have it together. Check this out. Yes, it's that time of year. It's cucumber time. And they're all over the place. Normally, I don't let the... Oh, by the way, these are the White Wonder cucumbers. I gave away seeds for this in the 2013 free seed giveaway. God, I hate this microphone. But anyway, I don't normally let them get that big. Now, this is not quite a pickling cucumber, but it's also not quite one of those long slicers. It's kind of in between. What I like about these is the skin is so soft and it's non-bitter. It takes forever for these things to go bitter. They really pretty much go all season long, and you have totally edible cucumbers, absolutely delicious. But the size that I like to eat these is, let me see. I think I can find you one. Of course I can find you one. They're all over the darn place. Oh, here we go. Take a look at this. This is the size I like to use them. See the little blossoms? You just pick that off. These are fine, but I like these. And I come out to the garden, I just pop these off and nibble on them. You can eat them with the skins and everything. Just wipe the little spines off and stuff. These are absolutely delicious. And don't worry about wasting your cucumbers. You may think that if you pick them too soon and you pick them really small, you're wasting your cucumbers. Actually, you're not, because the more you pick, the more you get. These are like beans. So go ahead and pick these things as much as you possibly can. Keep them off the vine, and that way the plant starts putting out more flowers and stuff. And keep them well watered while you're picking them, because cucumbers, if you don't water them enough, you will start getting bitter cucumbers. So keep them very well watered. Water extremely deep. Let the soil dry out just a little bit, but not too much, and then give it another good soaking. You may think that a little bit of water is enough. Trust me, it's not. You have to give these a good soaking because they love water. Think about it. These cucumbers take a lot of water to keep going. Okay, what's next on the breakfast menu? This is nuts. Look at all of these. I think I showed these once. These are called rat tail radishes, and this is what they look like. They're just seed pods. These are radish plants that are not grown for the roots. Normally you grow radish plants for the roots, and the roots are delicious. These are grown for the seed pods. Now, radishes will form flowers and seed pods, but not as profusely as these and not as fast. These produce just crazy fast, and you get all of these pods, and you just pick them, toss them in your mouth. And I suggest picking them when they're real small and young, because they're really delicate. They're not quite as hot, and these are fantastic. You take these and just toss them on your salad and or in your stir fries and stuff. Beautiful, isn't it? Beautiful, tender, delicious, and you get all of that radish flavor without having to worry about, oh no, my radishes aren't producing radishes. You got the radish flavor right here in a rat tail radish. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm going to probably let these dry out. I've eaten as many as I can, and I am just full up to my ears on these. But I think I'm going to save these, dry them out, and maybe give away some of the seeds and let people around the country or around the world here and there. I don't have enough for everybody on the planet, but you know, here and there, maybe I'll give some of these out and have people try and grow some rat tail radishes and see what they think, and they can give seeds to their friends and their friends, and we can start spreading these things all over, because I'd never heard of these till a friend of mine, Richard, on Facebook. He sent me some of these seeds complimentary, and I am so happy to be growing these. So thank you, Richard. Thank you so much for something original, fun, and spicy. I got cucumbers, I got rat tail radishes. This is parsley. This is Italian parsley. It's not the curly, you know, really tight parsley. It's a looser leaf parsley, but it has a lot more parsley flavor. If you've ever bitten into uncooked parsley, you may think, oh, it's just a spice. You know, it's not. It's a treat. And you can come out to your garden and pick a piece off. You know, a lot of these things that you see in your garden, you may have heard certain things about them, like, oh, you got to use them this way, you got to use them that way. You know, there are so many different ways to eat your plants. And me, I just come out here. I didn't rinse that off at all. I don't care. That is delicious. This is Wakefield, Jersey Wakefield cabbage, and it's young plants, and they haven't formed heads or anything like that. I don't know why, but they're awful young. I have some over on the other side that are starting to form heads. In the mornings, I come out here and I just toss a leaf in my mouth, and it's delicious. And a little bit of parsley, dill. The dill I don't eat. I just go like this. just rub it between my hands, and it smells like spring. It's beautiful. And it's going to start forming the heads. Dill is used in two different ways. You use the little ferns right here. You can use these in salads or in any kind of dish where you need dill, or you can toss it into a pickling. Most people will use the flower heads. You see that in pickles and stuff like that, but you don't necessarily need that. You can get a very mild, very delicate dill flavor by using the leaves. What I like to do is I just let them grow, and I do some pickling, but what I'll do is I'll let these grow up, and then I gather them all up, bundle them up, and I dry them in the house, and I hang them, and I get dill smell all winter long. It's a wonderful thing. And then behind me, this, oh, I just scared a whole bunch of little bee-like things off of here, sorry. This is cilantro. Cilantro is also known as coriander. Coriander is the seeds, well, in the United States, we call the seeds coriander, and then the leaves, cilantro. Same thing, they all smell the same. And this is a wonderful smelling, wonderful, delicious spice for Mexican cooking, things like that. They use it for a lot of different stuff. I love the smell. I use these in my fresh spring rolls. If you take this and just break it up, don't even chop it, break it. I learned this when I was a cook. They said, you never chop spices, you always tear them. And that brings out the oils and the flavors a lot better. And I know I'm just picking out here at my garden, but I don't care. That's what I do. And but anyway, coriander or cilantro is wonderful in fresh spring rolls. I made these a couple years ago. It is one of my all-time favorite summer treats, and that's why I grow this. Now, as far as preserving this, I don't dry these spices because they seem to lose a lot of flavor when I dry them. What I do is I just pick the leaves, throw them on a sheet, throw them in my chest freezer, and then they freeze, and then I take the dried leaves and put them in a Ziploc bag, and anytime I need cilantro, I just pick it up, throw it in my cooking, and it brings out that fresh cilantro flavor. Or some people have told me what they do is they take it and they mince it all up or throw it into a food processor with some water, and then they pour it into ice cube trays, and then they have cilantro ice cube, and you just toss it in your cooking. Fantastic idea, folks. Oh. Big ol' honkin' fight between some robins. You know, you think that birds are so peaceful and so beautiful. No, they're angry little things. They are angry, especially when I water the garden. The robins come out and they fight over position, because when you have moist soil, the worms come out. Robins know that. So the robins are out here just sucking up all the worms as I water the garden. And when I mow, the swallows, they go right in front of the mower, because this stirs up these moths in the thing. And the swallow goes zoom, and they swoop down and they grab the moths. So it's really kind of fun. When I move, and I told you in the last episode I'm going to be moving, I'm so excited. I'm so glad to finally get that out in the open, because yeah, I was just dying to tell you. And there are four places in Iowa that I'm going to be looking at next week, and it's going to be fun. I'm not going to film any of it because I'm in a real rush to look at them. But one of them, it took a long time, but I'm glad I waited. You know, it's tempting to eat all the leaves off of these as they grow. You know, One of the sucky parts about having a deep-rooted garden, I always promote watering deep so you get deep roots. My lettuce has a longer root system than I'm comfortable with. This is some kind of butter crunched lettuce. Somebody sent me some seeds for it. Take a look. It's not regular butter crunch, but it's really soft, really beautiful. Look at that. That's a lovely lettuce. And I only had a few seeds, so I planted them far apart, but I got some beautiful heads of lettuce off of this. And believe it or not, with all the gardening I've done throughout the years, this is the first actual head of lettuce I've ever grown. Oh, look at that. I'm dirty. The first head of lettuce I've ever grown. Normally, it's just leaves. I don't know why. I can't seem to get things to form heads. First year, first time, yep, it's a very first for me, and so I'm actually very, very proud of this. I wanted to have a salad last night, but I wanted to wait until today. Oops, it's falling apart. Oh no. It looked a lot better before I picked it. Really, it did. But anyway, yep, full head of lettuce. Feeling kind of small in the corn, are you? He used to walk in the corn, and I was so worried about him trampling it down. Now I don't have to worry about it at all. He walks through it like a forest, keeps everything out of the corn, and they say knee-high by the 4th of July. And I think I did a little bit better than knee-high. So that's a good thing. We'll see if I get any kind of corn out of this. I'm really not quite sure if I will or not because, stupid microphone wire. Anyway, it's growing in the shade of some mystery tree and my big apple tree that has all kinds of apples on it right now. But hopefully I'll get at least a little something out of here. And I'm not growing it for massive production. I was just growing it because I had no idea what else to grow in this spot this year. And I've grown pumpkins in here successfully, and you're supposed to only be able to grow those in the sunlight. So I thought, well, maybe I can pull a rabbit out of my hat and grow corn here. But no, it does grow really nice. It grows really nice. I composted this and it went boom. And remember, I was going to hill it up. I already did that too. So it's nice, solid plants. The only problem is I think it would have done a lot better. It would have been a lot stronger if I would have had full sun. But I'm not going to complain because it's a beautiful plant. And even if I don't get corn out of this, I'll just shred this up and feed it to my chickens. They'll love it. Every time I get a little tiny one that isn't doing so well or a leaf breaks off, I give it to the chickens and they love that. But anyway, my corn is doing good. Hopefully at the new place, I'm going to have enough space to be doing things like maybe more animals. If I'm in a remote enough area, I'm going to have maybe a peacock or two. And I even saw little pictures of little piggies. And even though I'm not going to, you know, butcher the pig, I thought, wow, it'd be kind of cool having a pig. I don't know why. I've just never had a pig before. And I thought, why not? Why not have a pig? It'd be something that, you know, I could, you know, I'd be raising it from a baby and hand feed it and stuff. And it would be like a pet. And that would make he would love it. Can you imagine him playing with a little pig? And maybe peacocks, guineas, things like that. I have no idea. The possibilities are endless. And I'm hoping that maybe it'll have a barn. I don't know. By the way, I'm going to be looking at 4 places in a week. So, oh, God, I should have wore something that mosquitoes can't push their needles through. I was, you know, filming this and I thought, ow, through the whole video. It turns out this shirt is so thin, the mosquitoes go right through it. The mosquitoes here are treacherous. Anyway, this is my garden for right now. I just wanted to show you a little bit of an update because I was feeling so good yesterday after everybody was posting their comments about how positive they feel about the move, just like I am. And I was really happy about that. I thought, oh, I got to get out there and film something. So that's what I did. Rascal and I came out here and we filmed. And the next place is going to be so much more fun. I'm glad you guys are coming along with us. I'm just grinning today from ear to ear, and it's not from the coffee this time. It's because I'm truly happy and I'm looking forward to some fun times ahead. Anyway, keep your fingers crossed. Hopefully I'll be roasting corn this... Ooh, stupidness. Oh, I hate mosquitoes. Oh, I hate... Yes, I do hate. Yes, Ray does hate. And what Ray hates is mosquitoes. I don't like those things. Nature really did mess up when they invented mosquitoes. There is no need for mosquitoes. If they cease to exist on this planet, I wouldn't shed a tear for those things. I know that sounds mean. I wouldn't mind getting rid of those things. Ow, they itch. They really itch. Ah, a robin just snagged 3 worms out of my... You little pig. 3 worms. Oh, well, I guess I got enough to go around, but still, come on, 3? She had this big old honking mass of worms in her beak. That's really kind of cool. Okay, I got to get going. Thanks, everybody, for joining me. And thank you so much for all the great comments on the last episode. I really do appreciate it. And next week, I do believe I'm going to show the tomatoes. I haven't shown them lately because they really aren't doing anything. They're growing. They got a whole bunch of little green tomatoes and nothing's really going on. I mean, they look wonderful, but I don't want to show the plants just for the sake of showing the plants. So I got to leave something for next week. Otherwise, I got nothing to do, right? Okay, I'll talk to you all soon. Thank you for joining me in the garden and have a great day. Bye. You're just sitting there, huh?